This video is brought to you by CoolStuffInc.com, where you can find cool stuff in stock.
Today's sweet shirt comes from Into the AM. This planetary spectral lighthouse is one of many awesome designs that you can find, and they're as comfortable as the shirts can be. So if you want something maybe without a logo, but a little bit of art, and you want it super comfortable and unique, do check out Into the AM, and using that link gets you a discount and supports the channel. So thank you to them for sending me today's apparel, and thanks to everybody who checks them out. Hello, and welcome back to another day in the arena. It's me, it's CGB. Today in the arena, the conclusion of the Shark Attack promotion with CoolStuffInc.com. It is the 21st. It ends today. It is your final chance to get any singles order from CoolStuffInc.com and get a CGB Shark token included with your order for free. Just a quick thank you to everybody who's placed orders and to CoolStuffInc themselves for believing in me enough to put my face on a token for marketing reasons. Is there anything cooler than a company that really just believes in you enough to market you, to kind of want to get on board with that? I gotta tell you, if you ever have the experience in your life after years of feeling like kind of an outsider, like seeing other people getting the big opportunities and getting their faces plastered on things, and then it happens to you, it will feel good. So it does mean a lot to me. And I'm saying that with a little bit of snarkiness, but not that much sarcasm. I love the token. I can't get enough of the token. I can't believe it every day that I'm on that token. So thank you to Cool Stuff Inc. for making that happen. And how are we going to conclude it? After that heartfelt, inspired intro, we're gonna play Rogues. No, CGB, no Rogues. Stop with the Rogues. It's a different build of Rogues. It's not a Lurrus deck, and it does change a lot of things about the deck and how it plays. So please bear with me. I think it's worth giving this version of Rogues a look. It's not just a gimmick for Shark Typhoon. I think this is actually where I want to be in the meta. Now, I tried many brews with Shark Typhoon and many builds of various decks with Shark Typhoon, but the line that you have to walk, beating Mono White and beating Sultai Ultimatum in this meta, is a very tough line to walk. And I think that it's time for good, solid tempo decks. And Rogues is one way to build an interesting take on half-control-y, half-tempo magic. But you have to get a little bit outside of the Lurrus grind. The Lurrus mill grind is a much better deck for milling out the opponent and draining them of their resources. It's oddly a really good control deck that can also just win on turn 4. This version of the deck, though, takes things in a different direction. It still has Rogues, but there's no Rune Crabs here. We have the Thieves Guild Enforcers, the Soaring Thought Thief, and the Brazen Borrower to be our attacking Rogues, and then we use ZARETH Sand the Trickster to try to steal the opponent's awesome permanents away from them. Whether it's their Kiora Best the Sea God out of Sultai Ultimatum, or you just put a Maul of Skyclaves on the ZARETH when you play against Mono White. It's some pretty sweet stuff, and it's an important aspect of the deck for beating multiple types of game plans. But I think my favorite part is that we get to run 8 counter spells with 4 Drown in the Lock and 4 Didn't Say Please to shut down the ultimatums, but we also get to run sweepers that are one-sided board clears because all of our creatures, except for those sharks we might make, are Rogues. So 3 copies of Crippling Fear can absolutely devastate the opponent when we are a very roguey attacking plan. The biggest problem that I had with ZARETH in the past is that ZARETH would come down, steal a thing, we'd feel really good. The opponent would do something like maybe Brazen Borrow the thing we stole to feel extra bad, and then they would gum up the board. They would play creatures that can block the ZARETH pretty easily, and our ZARETH would sit there just looking sad. But Crippling Fear moves all the small blockers out of the way, just completely removes them. It's absolutely brutal. So this card, this little addition from Kaldheim for this version of Rogues, I think is exactly what it needed. Shark Typhoon still holds a spot in the deck because you love having ways to make instant speed threats that keep the opponent on their toes. Plus, resolving a hard cast shark in the mirror, the rogue mirror, is usually lights out. If you have the option to do that, but they don't, you're at a little bit of an advantage. So, hence the Shark Typhoon. You can also, in theory, you know, play a Shark Typhoon and name Shark when you cast Crippling Fear. So it's not the end of the world to make a 4-4 Shark, wipe the opponent's board, and keep your other Sharks. That can happen. So that's the primary just gist of the deck. I want something that goes down the middle. I want something that can control the mono white aggros, and I want something that can just tempo out and play a few key counter spells and beat the ultimatum deck. It led me back to blue black. I know that you guys might be a little sick of the rogue gamers, but I don't find this kind of rogue deck, I don't find nearly as frustrating as Rune Crab Lurus, just Wind Robber you out, Value Town Rogues. Like, that's infuriating to play against. This one is more of a straightforward, like, I line some threats, I play them at the right time, I play a few key counter spells, I win by a couple inches, not by like 50 million grindy miles. So maybe you'll forgive me on this rogue deck, maybe you won't, but I hope you give it a try because it treated me very well in the arena. And over in the sideboard, we have 15 cards. Why? Why are they in the sideboard? CGB, you're the one in best of one. What is this sideboard doing here? This sideboard is here for those times when you steal a Raven's Warning and get it to chapter 3. You wouldn't want to be the nerd with no sideboard if you stole a Raven's Warning and got it to chapter 3, would you? No, you would not. So I built a sideboard for as if I had a Raven's Warning in my deck, because sometimes you just will. Just go ahead. Let me pretend that this is a thing that matters. I'm sure it happens all the time. This video is dedicated to Don Gilbert, who just renewed Twitch Prime for the third month. Thank you to everybody who made the pilgrimage over to Twitch once a month to renew Twitch Prime. It makes a huge difference to me, really helps me out. So I appreciate you. There is also a video and link below showing you how to link Twitch Prime to Amazon Prime so you can support your favorite streamer for free. Check that out in the description. Thank you so much. This video is dedicated to you, and we are continuing to collect those snow lands. So let me again show you how to pick up those beautiful suckers. If I can remember, it's always a thing for me. Oh, we've got to, let's get the mountain this time. So we got to do this. There they are. Do we do the one with the Mount Doom volcano? Or do we do the majestic Alpine slopes? Mount Doom volcano, obviously. That invokes the style of the Red Mage. All right, thanks one more time to Don Gilbert. Now let's dive in. Let the roguey nonsense begin. Oh yeah, this is how we do it. We should be on the play. We did that wrong. Let's see if it costs us the game. Four lands is a lot. All right, our opponent's on some kind of a mono black? Wow, look at the swamps. I don't think I'll need you, but I'm not sure. We just don't understand our opponent's deck yet. We need all the mills, even though this is a bit risky. Okay, 100% swamps in the graveyard. All right, there's something else. Try to hold on to the awakening. If I get their Terror Grid, I'm going to feel very good about that. We could go for the ZARETH here. But they've got something. They definitely have something. Soul Shatter. So we could counter that, put in another Enforcer. Or we could just into the story. Both are good. I don't really want to mill them a lot more because I'm worried that they're going to take advantage of their graveyard. They are a black deck. So let's just let this go and say go and see what they do. You have perfectly good options. We don't need to rogues go face Burr. Okay, that's a lot of land. But that's another end of the story, so it's fine. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. Can we get you to make a play? So that we can go get Zarethy. Opponent's just not moving. Okay. We can back Zareth up with a counter if the Enforcer gets into the attack phase. The way that they played previous turns implies that that's going to happen. But we'll see. Murderous Rider? I mean, yeah. Some kind of mono black control. So what do you think? Can Zareth get in? Soul Shatter. I will counter it. Doesn't look like there's a priority there. Gimme. No gimme. They don't like that very much. They do not like that at all. Looks familiar. Not a lot of cheap plays, though. And we're on the draw. I don't know about this hand. But Crippling Fear is good if they're aggressive, so we'll try it. We'll try. Temple of Abandon. All I think is Tybalt's trickery, immediately. Beastie. I think the Thieves Guild Enforcer might just get Bone Crushed, but it's not really doing anything else. But we have to get cards in their graveyard. If we don't do that, nothing good's gonna come of this. Two lands. See, if they resolve the beast next turn, we need to get more cards in their graveyard in order to drown them. I think I have to fetch blue here, because I don't think the drown is going to be helpful. I think I need to didn't say please their next spell, then drown the beast. We might get run over, you know, penalty for being on the draw. You just don't get to play. Interesting. We do this because we make them have another 1-1 or they can't attack us with the beast. And now we can counter said 1-1 or drown the 1-1. No. No. Alright, good old Gruul Adventures. I feel like I haven't played this matchup in forever. One card goes to the graveyard, and we get to story. Or we could play the tap land and plan to drown that card. I don't think they're going to add the card to the graveyard on their own. Not to mention, there's nothing wrong with using a drown. So let's play this and get Zareth ready. That's a good draw. There's only six cards in the graveyard. If they have double henge, I get super punished. No, I don't. I've got a Brazen Borrower. Can Crippling Fear that. No land. Down goes the beast. I think we say go. We might do the double borrower trick. And then ZARETH. See if they have that land. Because they might have been holding a land because they want a landfall trigger this turn, so we get it out of there. Uh-huh. Derp. So do we play around Bone Crusher Giant with this Borrower? We're not doing anything else with the mana. Oh, this is a tough one. I'm doing it. I'm going for it. I think the opponent has it. Let's see if they go for it right here, though. While I'm tapped out. Yeah, you. I hate you. Ugh. Makes me grouchy. So we can wait and see if they have another land and possibly flash in ZARETH for the ambush, but then what do? They probably Embercleave. So do we take a big hit here? Because what we can do is play the ZARETH, Crippling Fear, attack, and get their Great Henge. And I don't think they can kill me. Alright. I've talked myself into a line of play that is completely unreasonable. Oh, baby, they didn't. Cleave it. Cleave. There it is. Now Crippling Fear doesn't work. Could be worse, though. Okay, what do we get? We could get a Questing Beast or a Lovestruck Beast if we want to worry about sizing, but getting their Great Hench seems really good. Hi. Come to Papa. And there's our Brazen Borrower. So we're definitely going to bounce this. So I'm just going to play this tap land because there's nothing better to do with the rest of our mana. Pumps. And boing. Now's as good a time as any if they had another Henge. We also don't want to let them in combat when they could also cleave. So now they can't re-equip the cleave now that we've seen this land. So whatever they play, we can Crippling Fear it out of the way. Scoos! Alright. Well, there's a lot of good to be done here. Let's do this. Your stuff is dead. How do you feel? How does it feel to have dead stuff? Your dead stuff is mine. How does it feel? How does it feel? This should be fine. Tell me now, how do I feel? Edgy. Opponent will not give up. They have the Great and Mighty Embercleave, after all. Stomp my face. Okay. I mean, we can out-card them, we can also out-aggro them. Like, everything about this is pretty good. Perfect draw. Perfect draws. Baby, 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 baby. Should have just sent back the Bone Crusher Giant. I didn't want to take 2 damage. I'm greedy like that. Oh, that was delightful. Yorian! Well, this hand has some creatures and a counter and an into the story, so we'll keep it. And we're on the play? Oh my goodness. That's straight up cheating. Better not lose. All right, how to play it? Probably just lead with Enforcer into Thief. Do that thing. Opponent foretells. We could double Thief here, that's a lot, but this gets every mill possible, and every mill is useful against them. It reduces the options on an ultimatum that we're never letting resolve anyway, let's be clear. Pretty cool to draw that. We have Didn't Say Please. I guess Elspeth's Nightmare is a reason not to play something here. Alright, 3 mana, what you doing? That is the reason. Nope. Now their Vorinclex is gone and Elder Gargaroth is gone. Have a little bit of this. Have a little bit of that. Have a little bit of this. And we'll see if they're ready with the sweeper or if we get to go try to find a counterspell and hit them again. Definitely put the squeeze on them. Like, if they have another Elspeth's Nightmare, it doesn't kill anything. So they go with the Heartless Act to try to slow down the damage. They miss a land drop. You may as well concede. Let's go ahead and draw. We might hit something. They have something for a black. It must be Erebos' intervention. Oh, man. Oh, look at these. Look at these beauties. So we're going to hold up the passage. It bluffs that we might have another Thieves Guild. Yep. Good luck, Sultai. You do get to do that. That is that's about as good as they could hope for right there. That getting to sneak that in. Pretty good. Slam the Shark Typhoon. No. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Behold your demise. No land still, huh? Here comes a shark. I assume they have a removal spell for it, but this means they get hit by the Enforcer. And we get to draw a card, so it's still a pretty good deal for us. How are you gonna get out of this one? Oh no, my graveyard. What have I become? I'm now the person who rogues the Yorian decks and laughs as I do it. This is what this meta has made me. It's Magic, wow! I like the name. No blue. No blue, otherwise this hand would be a definite keep. And I get 2 draws to find it. Let's see, the opponent doesn't have a companion. I should assume they're an aggro deck, so I should keep the Crippling Fear and I should put away the Typhoon. Not a good hand. Very slow and on the draw. Crucial untapped land. Just please stop with that card. It makes me so mad. Oh my god, does that card make me mad. All right. Well, we can't kill it because there's no cards in the graveyard. Thieves Guild Enforcers are a long way from being good, and it might be way too big for a crippling fear. Like, just being on the draw, like, you're dead. You're just dead. That we can't cripple. Where are you gonna put the counter? Good choice. I had a feeling they would. They played that dog so aggressively. Like, putting the counter on the dog last turn. But yeah, we're just like dead here. We do have a counter next turn with the drown. And who knows? Stuff can happen. I guess we can pull off some death touchy things. Feels dead. But we do still have ZARETH. ZARETH can be nutty. All right, they go straight to combat. They put a counter on the Valkyrie. Everybody's in? How do we do this? This is a really tough decision. We do have to get this dog. So I guess that's the plan, get the dog. We're so cooked. I guess not. Crippling Fear, right? Crippling Fear is trying to give us a chance at this game. Down to 9. What do they play now that they've tapped us out? We can still draw an untapped land. Oh, Banishing Light? That's not that bad. And they take an Enforcer? That's not that bad. We don't draw the land, though. I need to kill this. They might put another counter on it. How do I make sure they put another counter on it? If I hold this back, they won't attack with this. They'll put a counter here and we can drown it, so... Or bounce it. Actually, we can bounce Banishing Light. I want to make sure this dies. Try to extend the game and get a Crippling Fear going. They do have 5 mana, so bouncing this... This is the last turn we're bouncing this is super advantageous. Block. Bounce. There is Lurrus. There is Savior. Okay, come on. Come on, land. Not there. The heck am I doing? Why am I so bad at magic? Alright, so we want to intercept the Savior, and then they have to play the Savior again. Try to keep their life total in check if we're not blocking with that thing. Man, would I love your Lurrus. I miss having it in the deck. Play a little Alseed, maybe? Okay, bring back Luminarch, of course. They did that first, so they're not playing the Valkyrie. Unless they're just gonna miss on a life. Okay, dog bails on the attack, smarty pants. Come on, untapped land! Okay, got there. Let's see if they block. I should have played the island to give myself a chance at a Zareth. But if they block here, it's really good for the crippling fear, which they may not expect. Oh my goodness. Let's go. I will have your toys. Got him down to one card. It's a Daxos. Baby. Baby, baby, baby. Luris is mine. Mine. Worth it. A little scared of a Sky Maw, but then we have life gain. Coming back the other way. Oh god. Those are huge. Alright, you're indestructible. So they have to block the Zareth or I get something from them, which means Luris gets through. So let's go destroy you. All right, good. Angels negated. It looked like we were way ahead. The angels messed it up. For sure. And back to top decks. 17-9. A Heliod off the top. Off the top combines with Daxos. You wanna rumble? I've got Death Touch. I'm not afraid of you. Maybe I was supposed to pay three and bring this out. I wanted to hold the Awakening, but maybe that was wrong. Mana efficiency? Yeah, they know about this. They don't know about this. We might get to block that Daxos yet. That indestructible Heliod, though, is terrifying. Okay, nothing to get back with Belurus right this second. Oh god. Let's go. Just put all those angel-y, cleric-y things in your graveyard. Where they belong. So, take your damage. It's magic! Wow! Damage. Alright. Scry me up something good. Something good. Something so good. Good, I said. I guess that gets back Zareth, but we'll draw another land at some point. Three straight solid, I mean solid draws. Keeping our opponent in this game. But they haven't dealt with the Luris yet. Man, we were so far ahead. Alright. Come on down, Lil Enforcer. If we can't kill him, we'll mill him. They're at 18, so we're doing pretty good on that front. Two more Daxos. Let's get the double mill before we block. Ten cards. I think we got this. All right. So here, take three. Could have also taken the hit from Heliod and killed the Daxos, which might have been better. Might have. Get him again. See, if I attack with all these, do they have to block? All right, six cards. It mills for two. If a rogue dies and I get it back, I win. So, I guess the damage doesn't really matter. We'll just go like this. Big brain takes it. And the slow rolled awakening for the lethal. No library for you, it's magic! Wow! I suppose we can keep it. It was close to bad, but thought the Finda didn't say please should fill the graveyard. Enough for Drown to do a thing, and Shark Typhoon's never just absolutely terrible. Lava fish. Oh, we're not here for some friendly, silly game of magic. So they don't see Allurus. They might not expect the Thought Thief. Let's see if they walk into it. Intelligence test! And none was found. We'll say hello now. There you go. There you go. See? We'll see. Do they have a glass casket for the one-upsmanship? Ah, speaker. Okay. Start the beats. Let's see if they attack with that speaker now. The important thing is not to tap out in a way that lets them Lurrus us. That's an obnoxious card. How to do this? If we let it resolve, they might attack with the speaker and then we trade it with the shark, but I don't know if that's great. We'll just do this. But we can't let them have a Lurrus. Lurrus takes over the game big time. This lets us make a 2-2 shark if we decide to go for ambush mode. Also, now we can allow like a Heliod to resolve. Like, if I had known I had a Brazen Borrower, I wouldn't have even countered it. That's fine. What do you guys think? Do we take a Lurrus risk because they have a Savior? I think so. We have a Borrower and they can't play another thing this turn. Lets it die. So is this Lurrus? It is. All right, so we can bounce the Lurrus and try this again. Ooh, We can have our own Luris. Their Luris is better than our Luris, though, so let's be patient on that front. More rogues, can't hurt. Two mana open, what do you think the rogues player has? It's drowning the lock. Shocking. Dun, 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 dun. Are we in the right phase? It says next to damage, so I should be able to do this now. Okay, you gotta watch it with that card. ZARETH! So many interesting cards, but I will have Luris. Because rogues love Luris, and Luris loves rogues, and even though Luris can't be with us in this build, ZARETH will always find her. Rude. How rude. How dare you target your own nightmare kitten. So when this dies, because that's the owner, they do get a 3-3. We do not. Would you like to attack? Good choice. Oh, we could do it again. We could do it again. But they don't have good blocks yet. They just start chumping with the savior, I suppose. Let's get some more mills. Smite. Let's hit them a little harder, yeah? Yeah. We could legend rule our own ZARETH. There's still nothing to get back, so I don't think it's very good. Block like this. Okay. So their plan is to draw Luris, I suppose. We also want to play the Brazen Borrower, because then we can ZARETH back the Borrower and have a Petty Theft. So are you dead? Lethal threat. Plus more. Oh, they're friendly. Okay, I'll give you a good game since you said it and you're nice. You seem to get my humor. I appreciate you. No blocking choices to be made. Feels good to beat a mono white without having to draw the Crippling Fear. Means we can still do it. On the play, tap land, Thought Thief, Borrower. Will we draw land? I'll give it a shot. I mean, it's a pretty nice hand. I don't know which land we'll draw though. So I don't know if I should lead on the passage or just play this on black, plan to play this on blue. Let's give ourselves a chance for the perfect curve with the Enforcer. Opponent annoyed with my speed of play. Ha! Get that Luminarch Aspirant out of here. Let's see if they have another one. They usually do. Okay. Every time, man. They've always got... They got it! It's like their deck's designed to do stuff. Oh, no attack, though. Not willing to make that trade. Double speaker draw. Okay. Well... They're... That's... I think that's good for us. Until they play an aspirant. Like... They can't really attack with those. They don't do much. Not to mention we have Thought Thief. But they don't know that yet. But they'll have to think about it. We are mana screwed. We need to make sure every turn is about extending the game to the point where we draw into what we need. Let's see if they have land. They have land number three. They have aspirant. Counterspell. That card's too good. Force them to use the dog? Not yet. Getting beat up, though. That's pretty good. Can't save both. This is tough. But I think I have to drown that speaker. I could also take a hit, bounce it on end step. It could definitely have something worse. But not much. Like, if they play Lurrus here, got them, you know? Daxos. Daxos is annoying, but I can live with it. We have a block here. The opponent can, like, try to use their castle, make a 1-1 grow this bigger, then we bounce it. That's pretty good. Okay, they draw fountain, so they don't need that anymore. So now I think we let them through. And see if they go for the extra damage. If they do, we get to bounce Daxos. They go for lifelink. Let it hit and then bounce it on end step. That way they can't replay it and we get a whole turn before it attacks us again. And they don't have the mana for a 1-1. And they won't have it next turn unless they top deck a land. Man, this draw is an infuriating one, isn't it? Uh-huh. And it's back. And now they have the mana to make the 1-1. So let's do it again. Okay. What do we want? make it good. So, we could get a radiant fountain. there's a sky mall, which could keep Daxos getting in, because starting next turn, Daxos gets blocked. There's Alcide, which we could sack to protect Daxos. Or not Daxos. I keep saying Daxos. Zareth. Yeah. Gotta keep the power going. Can they top deck their way out of this? Let's find out. No! Not that! Come on! Come on! No! Their best frickin' draw! No! I have to lose to that bullshit. Oh my god. Unbelievable. I can't even get another blue source. My opponent can draw like that. What a load of garbage. My Heliod doesn't do anything. There's not another Alcide. Yeah, we have no chance, right? No chance whatsoever. I guess I take a lifelinker to chump block with. Oh my god. What a stupid draw. I can't. Oh, that hurts. That really hurts. And we are back for the post-game wraps, and you know what? Thank you very, very much to you, viewer, for staying and watching and giving Rogues a chance, because I think there is good in them, you know? There's something good in there. They've got a dark side, and they're a bit too annoying a good amount of the time, but I think this build, like, serves the right purpose. We have to punish Sultai Ultimatum players a little bit. They're running too free. Same thing with Mono White. They're just building these wide boards of little nerds with indestructible and protection from this and protection from that. And we gotta check them a little bit. So I think that Rogues was a good pick to do it. I enjoyed playing this deck quite a bit, and I think you should give it a chance if you have it in you to play Rogues. So I know. If you dislike the video, I understand. Thumbs downs don't actually hurt my channel very much. Bubble burster for my haters, but they actually help just as much as a thumbs up. A reaction is a good reaction. So if you thumbs down the channel, you don't have to feel bad about that. I'm still glad you're here. I'm still glad that you watch the show. And I do hope you try this version of Rogues, because this version with Crippling Fear, I feel, is a lot better than the other version with Crippling Fear. So, where Crippling Fear is good in the meta, this deck is pretty sweet in the meta. It's good stuff. Thank you to Into the AM for dropping the shirt. Please check that out in the description. Thank you so much to Cool Stuff Inc. for the Shark Attack promotion and bringing back the Shark Week and a Half of content. That's always very fun for me, as Shark Typhoon is one of my favorite cards. Absolutely. And thank you to all of you, the members and the Twitch Prime subscribers. You guys are the reason for it all. You're cool.